Hey guys, Chit Fahadens here with a new tutorial for you. I recently wrote a big article on phone anamorphics, and since then I've been using my Moment anamorphic lens a lot more. The problem is I needed filters, and I didn't feel like spending 40 bucks plus shipping plus waiting for Moment's original filter holder. So that's what we're gonna be making today. On that note, this video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is a learning platform and they got tons and tons of content in there. I'm taking a few classes on motion design and After Effects since that's my day job and there's always room to improve. And classes are focused on creative subjects such as photography, film and video, illustration, animation, graphic design, creative writing, music, and much more. You get to pick the subjects you're most interested when signing up, and Skillshare starts to give you suggestions of what you could like after those ones are done. I find it interesting that it saves me from digging for hours for the next subject I want to learn. I highly recommend you guys check it out. There's a link in the description that gives you 2 months of free access. Now, let's get back to this Moment lens. The goal is to give it regular threads and allow you to use normal, cheap filters on it. Filters are round, while this little thing is square. And that's the first problem to tackle. Using a caliper, I measured the width and the length of the lens and created the shape in Fusion 360. Then I decided which filter size I wanted to use. Moment's original clamp is 62mm and I felt I could outdo them.
So I picked 52mm.
The reason I went for a smaller size is because smaller filters are also lighter. I'm pairing this whole thing with a gimbal, so I want it to be as light as possible. Next, I went to Amazon and got the cheapest 52mm UV filter I could find. And that's all the money I spent on this project. I had only one criteria besides the size. The filter had to have a screw locking ring for the glass. In many slim filters these days, the glass is glued into place. That won't work here unless you want to use super glue, which I don't really recommend. As soon as the filter arrived, I removed the glass, AKA threw it out, and took some more measurements of the ring. With those numbers and the lens's numbers, I was ready to model my own clamp. Then I 3D printed in black PLA. In a step-by-step, get the filter ring, take out the locking part, and insert the 3D printed part in there. Everything should be flush and the 3D print shouldn't go completely through. Use the locking part to, well, lock our print into place, and then insert the lens through the back. It's a tight fit, but that makes sure nothing will randomly fall apart while you're shooting. Now you're set and ready to roll. My arsenal of filters consists of a variable ND and a handful of diopters. I didn't get a lens cap, but I highly recommend it. To save you time, I have a link below for the 3D printed model as well as the Amazon filter I got. Those links only work if you subscribe and like this video. Not really, but I had to try. I'm sure you can create clamps for other lens sizes on your own just as easily. And if you need to learn some Fusion 360, check out Skillshare. They got some classes in there. Let me know if this hack works for you and what are your thoughts on shooting with anamorphic on your phone. I still need to work on my style, but I feel it's getting somewhere. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next week. Chit Fahadens out.